Porcupine is a small and very tough competitor. One of the toughest prey for predators. They can seriously injure or even kill lions and leopards. With such a small but dangerous creature, dazed predators can fight. A prey with which leopards and lions will fight without blinking. Lions and leopards need to be very careful when attacking the porcupine. It is not easy to catch the arrowed porcupine by the neck. The porcupine with the arrow shows his thorns by turning his back to the side where the move is coming. Predators and scavengers who attack unstable and careless become targets of thorns. Some leopards and lions may die due to thorns hitting the heart. They remove the thorns that hit the body as a result of long efforts. Leopards regularly kill and eat porcupine, and generally hunt on any animal which they feel able to defeat them. The leopard is a clever creature, so he can tell that the quill's defense is dangerous or at least painful. However, the quills do not appear on the bottom, so he tries to tuck his paws, sometimes even his face, under the porcupine, to turn it so that his mouth is in the area which has no defense. On the other hand, porcupine keeps turning in order to present its tail quills, which are the longest, towards the leopard. Keeping it at the furthest possible distance, and it seems to instinctively know that running is not an option. Porcupines are Africa's largest rodent and the second largest rodent in the world. Make formidable foes, and many a predator, including lions, has ended up quills stuck in their faces or paws. The quills sometimes fall out easily, but they can cause nasty wounds. Which, if they become infected, inhibit the predator's ability to hunt, and extreme cases can result in death. While porcupines may seem harmless, they have been known in the past to kill lions. Their trademark quills are released as a defense mechanism when predators get to close, and these can cause nasty wounds that can eventually lead to deadly infections. This fight, which is not easy for the porcupine with arrows, is like a breathtaking battle in nature. The arrowed porcupine can stand up to any predator with its large spines on this gorgeous dorsal area. When a snake eats a porcupine, the animal's quills are left undigested and are easily detectable in the snake's gut. Sometimes, the quills will even pierce all the way through the snake's body. But there's no word yet on whether this particular snake died because it was pierced by quills, or because it fell off a ledge, or because it was pierced by quills as a result of falling off the ledge. cheetahs are known to be the fastest land animal in the world. Reaching speeds of up to 60 miles per hour in a few seconds flat. Despite this speed, it is short burst, meaning their hunting tactics must be spot on to ensure capturing prey. The stalk is what they're good at. They crouch and lie in wait until the prey has averted their eyes, at which time the cheetah will continue moving forward slowly. While cheetahs are lean, to give them speed, they aren't especially strong. When a cheetah kills its prey, it attempts to subdue its food by latching on to the throat and suffocating the animal. Antelopes have extremely developed senses which help them detect predators while they still have time to escape. They are quick runners, some of them can reach up to 43 miles per hour. However, their running speed is still inferior to the cheetah. The antelope can never outrun the cheetah, but it can survive the chase if it twists and turns sharply at the last minute. The predators turned out to be significantly faster and more powerful than their prey. However, at lower speeds they were unable to match antelope for maneuverability, allowing these animals a chance of escape. As we know, almost all predatory cats can be very fast and strong, but they are weak in terms of stamina. On the other hand, prey such as zebras and antelope ran not as fast as predators, but stronger in terms of stamina. If a cheetah does not catch its prey during the first burst of speed, it will give up and rest for another try. However, if the prey has been caught, it would be difficult for them to escape. Although it will seem that they will be free, because their efforts to escape are supported by strong stamina. In the end, they will lose too. This is because predators such as the cheetah will bite the neck or throat, which is the vital point of their prey. Thank you. So, the stamina of their prey would be lost along with the defeat. Please like this video and subscribe to BV Animal Documentary if you want more videos like this. Thanks for watching.